David has a question here. I've begun rotating my cows and sheep on very sandy soils in zone 8, Texas. In addition to the ways rotation or grazing will help the soil, what else can I do to increase organic matter and water holding capacity in these pastures? Are there different techniques I should be applying to cover short-term and long-term? Well, adding tree forage is a big thing. So here we have a laneway, and we've got a beef cow at the back and a dairy cow at the front, or a dairy cow cross at the front. We're milking at the moment. And we have this laneway of electric fence. So this goes 3 kilometers all the way around Zaytuna Farm, and there's 44 gates we can open and put a mobile electric fence line out, or a double line with pigtail, little pigtail temporary tread-in fence pegs, posts. This allows us to move the animals in a rotation. That means we can change the size of the paddock to the seasonal conditions. We can speed up the rotation or slow it down as we like, but we're grazing in amongst our swale systems and our trees. Now there's a lot of hangover forage, so they're gaining a lot of feed from the trees, which are much deeper rooted, of course, than the pastures. If your trees are on swales, the swales are hydrating the landscape from pasture, from the swale to the pasture to the swale. Now, because they're on contour and your grazing system's now on contour top and bottom, the cattle will come up to the shade like these girls are here and cool off, or in winter they'll get out on the sun. So they'll tend to walk the fence lines, especially when they're on contour. So that manure on the top line will flow downward rain into the pasture. The manure on the bottom line will flow down to the swale. And if there's enough rain, that'll dilute all the way down the swale and fertilize the tree roots on the swale, which will give you more hangover pasture on the next, hangover forage on the next pasture. So it's about introducing trees into the system with their deeper tap roots, with their roots that can bring up minerals, relieve the pasture, and then you've got a larger, longer, deeper cycling of nutrient to your animals. Now you can also go through your pasture on contour with a Wallace plow or a yeoman's plow every now and again and deep rip without totally changing the structure of the soil. This is a fine, sharp rip line, and reseed extra herbage in, or just relieve compaction if you've made a little bit of a mistake. But usually you can set it up so you're imprinting the ground, you're taking off all the grasses and herbs, and with the right conditions, you can seed into the imprinting and diversify your pasture that way. And your return cycles are what you try and judge to get the best feed again. So by aiming in that direction, you can reduce the amount of area you need to graze, you can increase the amount of tree cover, you can increase the amount of diversity in your pastures and your trees, and you can rehydrate the landscape at the same time. Now that all comes up in the animal's health. You can also introduce minerals into occasional feed. So you can use the sea minerals of kelp, which will have all the minerals of the ocean, and diverse rock dusts, which can have all the all rock minerals we use, which has got all the minerals of the land. So all the land, all the sea minerals. You can add that into feeds. You can buy biodynamic lick blocks that have all those minerals in, and they become, they go through the cow with its four stomachs and become plant soluble when they plop out the other end. Of course, everything the cow drinks also comes out the other end as an enhanced product called urine. You know, most of what the cow eats comes out the other end as high quality manure. If that's highly mineralized, it's almost like you're having a minor glaciation event across your farm and your pastures and your swale diluted nutrient systems, because the ice ages of history caused massive ice sheets to grind rock minerals and mineralize the earth. Well, you can mineralize your farm through mineralizing your cow feed at times and distributing that out through your manure everywhere. There's all kinds of things you can do by putting animals to work, doing what they love to do, and at the same time improving their health and improving the quality of their product while you're increasing the quality of your farm and the quality of your farm environment. And this doesn't naturally happen. This is our design applied with intelligence and efficiency and care through animals.